A number of leaks of private data have made headlines recently in China, and most cell phone users have taken a call from a stranger greeting them by name, which turns out simply to be a marketing or a sales call or even a scam. And as more and more private information is stored online or exchanged over social networking sites, discussion has grown over just what is private in today's society and how personal information of any kind can be kept private. A dearth of clear legislation on where the lines between public and private lie doesn't really help much. So how do people on the streets of Beijing feel about what's private and what's not? And how do they protect themselves and their information? Our researcher Cao Lili went out to ask.
I think privacy covers a lot of things, such as how much I earn a month or anything that I don't want others to know. My phone number has been leaked and I get junk messages, prank calls and cold calls. I think that's because I have filled out so many forms. It would be better if people who steal others' phone numbers were dealt with much more severely by the law.
I don't want others to know my address, my child's school address and my phone numbers. Once my phone number was leaked, someone called to say my child was in intense care and I needed to send $5,000 urgently. But when I called his teacher to check, I discovered it was a scam. I think my number may have been leaked unintentionally by the school when we filled in some forms. I guess it's very difficult to avoid.
During a job interview, I was asked whether I had a girlfriend. I think that's private information. They shouldn't ask that. Oh, and someone got into my QQ chat account once. You should have security software on your computer to make sure your account details are safe and use a strong password. And you should avoid logging in on public computers, especially in an internet cafe.
Credit card information should be kept top secret. I think the leaking of phone numbers had to be done to phone operators since they are the only ones who have the information. We need a software on our phones to block unsolicited messages and we should report it when it happens.
I think private information includes ID information, family address, phone numbers, and other personal things. I bought insurance at one company, but I got lots of calls from other insurance companies afterwards. I think my information was leaked by a worker who quit this company and took it to other ones.